every time I step in the motherfucking gym, I work arms because I was determined to get some big ass motherfucking arms.
Maybe that worked for C.T. Fletcher to get big arms, but I wouldn't try out the same concept for your running. The idea that to run fast, you have to go fast is thrown around a lot, and it's true to some extent, but that doesn't mean you should go fast every time you run. And believe it or not, going fast doesn't automatically make you faster in and of itself. For simplicity's sake, we can think of the process of improvement in terms of the stress-adaptation cycle. For the stress, we are putting some aspect of our body through something a little above and beyond what it is used to. In the period immediately following the stressor, it won't perform as well. You will feel a little tired, won't be able to run as fast, and may feel a little sore. But during that period of tiredness, ideally our body goes to work remodeling itself in some way, so after a period of recovery, we emerge stronger, faster, and fitter, just a little bit better than before. And if we keep it up over time, it can look like this, where a new stressor keeps coming along at just the right time to raise us up to a new level. The problem is, it's hard to tell when your body is ready for a new stressor and how much and what type of stress is just the right amount to cause an adaptation. On the one hand, you could mess up by stressing yourself too much, so your performance plunges way down and it takes too long to recover, and you likely don't emerge stronger. Or even if you do emerge stronger, you might have been better served by a less severe stressor, so you could get more stressors in during that period of time. On the other hand, you could go the opposite way and train so light that you recover quickly to baseline and don't improve. This is actually more likely to occur after you get a little more used to training, since eventually you will get to the point where workouts that once gave you an adaptation are no longer enough of a stressor to cause adaptation anymore, and you will just stay the same. The other error is messing up the timing, especially re-stressing yourself too early in the recovery process, digging yourself deeper and deeper into an overtraining and injury risk hole. So once you crank out a hard workout, you might feel like, hey, I've put in the work and now I can spend the next day or two doing other things I want to do. Stay up late, I'll eat what I want, I'll catch up on lots of busy work. But it's actually in this period of recovery that your body is rebuilding itself, and you want to do everything you can to make sure you don't interrupt the process by giving your body other things to worry about. Otherwise, it will redirect its resources to helping you stay up late working instead of helping you recover faster and stronger. So you can see, when we look at this model of the stress adaptation cycle, it's important to both give yourself enough time and space to recover well and to mix it up throughout your weeks. It's often been said, run your hard days hard and your easy days easy. But you can also think of mixing it up in terms of the type of stress. So even if you are focused on improving speed at one distance, still try to include some variety into your workouts. And be sure to give yourself plenty of time and space to recover.